Hi, and welcome back to my channel. I'm so glad that you can join me. I am Nikki Garcia, and on today, we're going to review the fleshly work of uncleanness. This is detailed in Galatians 5:19 through 21. So let's go ahead on and try to review that real fast. Verse 19, now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanliness, lasciviousness. Verse 20, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies. Verse 21, envyings, murders, drunkenness, reveling, and such like, of the which I tell you before, as I have told you in times past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. As I said earlier, our focus today is on the fleshly work of uncleanness. Before I can delve into that, I want to give some preliminary information that will help explain and lay the foundation of the mental work that is necessary to deal with uncleanness. Let's start this conversation off by explaining sin. What is sin? Dictionary.com defines sin as an immoral act considered to be a transgression against a divine law. A divine law basically means the law of God. Now, let's explore an immoral act. When a person is moral, there is a set of beliefs that govern their lives that is righteous. Righteous means it complies to the law of God. When you are immoral, then your beliefs are not in right standing with God. Those beliefs in your life are antichrist or unrighteous. Let's now review beliefs. What are beliefs? These are deeply rooted ideas that fuse one character and is in essence the sum total of man's heart. What is the heart? The heart is the subconscious mind. It is the place that you innately react from because your thoughts have developed a stronghold and you operate from this mindset. Let this sit right there. A stronghold is your mind being set. Let's explain it like this. Everything starts off in short-term memory, and then it eventually goes into long-term memory when it is done over and over and over again. But everything that is not done over and over again stays in short-term, and the mind just dumps it, right? And so this is when your mind is set. That means you do it so many times over and over and over again that it begins to build a stronghold within you, and it is something that you do innately. I want to explain mindset from this perspective. In mathematics, when you're given a problem, they may give you a set, or it can be called a mathematical set. From this set of variables, you can now answer a problem. So mindset is the way your brain responds and answers the issues of life. Your responses are now based out of moral and immoral code that shape ultimately who you are. Now that we have looked at morality and immorality, we can see that a moral act is an action that one takes out of their mindset that goes against the law of God. And this is considered a transgression. What is a transgression? Transgressions are acts that go against a law, rule, or code of conduct and offense. And all of us have been involved in some manner of transgression. So now I want to review righteousness versus unrighteousness. When a person commits any transgression against the law, this particular act is what makes them unrighteous. It causes one to no longer be in right standing with God. How does one become righteous? It's not by works that any man should boast, but it is by repentance. 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, repentance, then they will hear from heaven and I will heal their land. Now that this is explained, we have laid the foundation to further expand on what uncleanness is. To be unclean. Matthew 23:27, let's look at that. It said, woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for ye are like whited sepulchres, which indeed appear beautiful on the outward, but are within full of dead men's bones and of all uncleanness. If you ever observe leprosy in the Bible, you would see when a person acquired this disease, they were put outside the camp for being unclean. No one was allowed to touch this person or come near this person for a period of time because they would become unclean as well and would be kicked out of the camp also. So let's discuss, what is leprosy? Leprosy is caused by an infection with bacterium, Mycobacterium leprae. It mainly affects the skin, eyes, nose, and peripheral nerves. Peripheral nerves are nerves that reside outside the brain and spinal cord. They relay information between your brain and the rest of your body. Symptoms include light colored or red skin patches with reduced sensation, numbness, and weakness in hands and feet. If anyone was infected with this disease, they were highly contagious. You were forbidden to go near this person because you too will become infected. Going back to our scripture reference, Matthew 23:27, this highly contagious disease in this case was the scribes and Pharisees. The Bible says, woe unto you. This means judgment unto you. Then it proceeds to say, paraphrasing, you don't look contagious. You look beautiful on the outside, just like a beautiful coffin. But on the inside, you're dead as a corpse. And that's what the Greek translation says. You look like a corpse, a dead body, and have all manner of uncleanness, meaning you got a lot of sores on the inside and you look like a sick leopard inwardly. In other words, do not be deceived. You look beautiful to behold, but you are highly contagious. And if anyone comes in contact with you, they will partake of only the dead thing that lies within. In essence, you Pharisees hold many in contempt of not upholding a righteous standard when you yourselves are guilty of this very thing. Another example of this is when drinking something cold, your entire body cools down. So you become cold from the inside out. Then you may eventually need a jacket or something to warm yourself back up. What is going on the inside isn't really evident until you see the jacket, all right? So what does someone who is clean look like? Let's review 2 Corinthians 10:5 in the Passion Translation. We can demolish every deceptive fantasy that opposes God and break through every arrogant attitude that is raised up in defiance of the true knowledge of God. We capture like prisoners of war every thought and insist that it bow in obedience to the Anointed One. This is very pertinent in uncleanness, and I will explain this through a dream I had. One day, I had this dream. When I was younger and I went to the movies, there was this movie projector. It projected light onto the screen. Through this light, this false light, an image is projected on a screen. In order for the brain to receive signals, understanding, everything is transmitted through light. This light comes through the eyes, and whatever is received through the eyes is transmitted to the brain. Light transmission through the eyes works like this. According to the National Eye Institute, when light hits the retina, a light sensitive layer of the tissue in the back of the eye, special cells called photoreceptors turn the light into electrical signals. These electrical signals travel from the retina through the optic nerve to the brain. Then the brain turns the signals into the images you see. This is how the enemy projects images or sows tares, seeds into our lives. The movie screen, the TV screen, our cell phone lights, all of these lights are projecting an image and sowing seeds into our lives, casting someone else's vision of uncleanness into our lives. Our lives are becoming illuminated with the various signals being sent to the optical nerve. Then the brain turns the signals into the images you see, which is us. We become the sum total of all the seeds, images that we have allowed to illuminate our eyes every single day, moment by moment, minute by minute. This is the reason the Bible tells us in Romans 12:1-2, going back to our very important scripture, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. You have to allow the illumination of the word into your soul to counterattack the images that the false light has tried to conform you into. So now going back to 2 Corinthians 10, verse 5, someone who is clean enforces this scripture every day. We can demolish every deceptive fantasy that opposes God and break through every arrogant attitude that is raised up in defiance of the true knowledge of God. We capture like prisoners of war every thought and insist that it bow in obedience to the Anointed One. Let's talk about this. God has already given us the blueprint in the Bible to utilize this strategy against the enemy. In Luke 10, 18 through 20, the Message Bible states it like this. Jesus said, I know I saw Satan fall, a bolt of lightning out of the sky. See what I've given you. Safe passage as you walk on snakes and scorpions and protection from every assault of the enemy. No one can put a hand on you. All the same, the great triumph is not your authority over evil, but in God's authority over you and presence with you. Not what you do for God, but what God does for you. That's the agenda for rejoicing. When Lucifer decided that he was going to exalt his throne above God, and there was this rebellion in the heavens, what did God do? He cast him down. He stripped him of everything. He stripped him of his authority. He stripped him of his power. He stripped him! In Luke 10, 18 through 20 above, he gave you power and authority over him through Christ Jesus. And now we can cast him down. He was cast down to earth. When God cast him down, the same thing happened when he beguiled Eve. When God went to render judgment, he cast him down again. And this time he said, and the woman's seed shall bruise your head. Now man even has power and authority to cast Satan down just as God did. A clean person must have the word in their lives so that uncleanness does not make them contagiously resistant to the knowledge of God. A clean person isn't resistant to God. They are constantly bringing into captivity everything that resists God in their mind, thinking, sleeping in every aspect of their lives. Well, that's it for today. That is our conversation on uncleanness. I thank you so much for joining me. It has been a wonderful time of Bible study. Amen. If you want to read the blog about this, visit lifegivingrhema.com and we will see each other soon. Just remember that God loves you and I do too. Amen. Bye-bye now.